Hi, welcome to Microsoft Build 2018. I'm Jeff Sackowitz, a program manager on Microsoft Graph. In this video, I'll give you an overview of the Microsoft Graph webhooks and Delta Query capabilities, tell you about some exciting new features, and show you how you can use them to keep important information up to date in your apps. I'll start by explaining what Microsoft Graph is to give you some context. For the rest of the video, I'll go over how you can use webhooks and Delta Query to learn about changes to data efficiently. We'll specifically focus on some newly available features that have been highly requested by our developer community, and I'll show them to you with a quick demo. So what is the Microsoft Graph? If I were to give it a textbook definition, I'd say that it's a unified REST API and comprehensive developer experience for integrating with the data and intelligence exposed by Microsoft services. But what does this actually mean? Microsoft Graph is your one-stop shop for accessing data, relationships, and insights across Microsoft 365. It's a REST API that lets you build rich applications that integrate with services used by over 100 million active users. These services include Azure Active Directory, SharePoint, OneDrive, Outlook, Teams, Intune, Windows, and more. There's also some exciting new security APIs, and even APIs built specifically for the education space. All in all, there are over 8 trillion resources available in Microsoft Graph. Now let's talk about webhooks. This capability allows web apps to subscribe to push notifications for Microsoft Graph resources. They can be used to inform the app about created, updated, or deleted entities in the graph. These notifications are just a poke. They don't contain any data. So after getting notified, your application should call back to the graph to see exactly what has changed. We'll talk about how Delta Query fits in this picture in just a moment. I'm very excited to announce that webhook subscriptions for Azure AD users and groups are now available in the Microsoft Graph V1 endpoint, meaning that they're ready for use in production applications today. Another cool addition to webhooks is the new List Subscription API, which allows developers to see what webhook subscriptions have been created by their apps. In certain scenarios, an app might need to see all the subscriptions that have been created for a given user or organization. And we have a new permission that apps can request in order to do this, subscription.read.all. This is especially useful in audit and compliance situations, but keep in mind this permission is highly privileged. It requires admin consent and only should be requested if absolutely necessary in a given scenario. And likewise, admins should only grant it if they really trust the app. Okay, now let's talk about Delta Query. This capability enables applications to discover newly created, updated, or deleted entities without performing a full read with every request. It's basically a Get Changes API. Applications with local data stores can use Delta Query to efficiently synchronize data with Microsoft Graph. Stateless apps without local data stores can also take advantage of it by using it to perform simple change tracking on the resources they're interested in. We also have some great new capabilities available for Delta Query. This includes the ability to track changes to specific Azure AD users and groups using the V1 endpoint instead of all users and groups in the entire tenant. As far as preview features go, Delta Query can now be used for planner entities on the beta endpoint, and clients using Delta Query with Azure AD resources can use token equals latest to ask for a Delta token only without having to parse through the entire payload of results first. All right, now let's jump into some demos. All right, so now let's take a look at what Delta Query and webhooks look like when they're used together. So imagine you're building a workflow that monitors for when users leave the sales department in order to assign their open sales lead to their manager. So I'm here in Graph Explorer, and I'm going to kick this off using Delta Query. So I could just tack on /delta to the end of my normal /users query, but in this case, I'm going to use some query parameters to just get back the data I actually care about. So first things first, I'm only going to go back to the department, because this is the only attribute that I care about, whether it's changed. I'm also going to use a filter here and just track changes for two users that I know are currently in the sales department. This will avoid me having to deal with responses I don't care about for when users in the rest of the organization change. So let's go ahead and run this query and see what we get back. All right, so we get back two users who are in the sales department, and we get back a next link, which means there might be some more data to be retrieved. Let's use the next link. In this case, there is no more data. I've got reached the end of my pages, but I do get a Delta link letting me know, basically this is my sync token that I'm gonna keep and use when I actually wanna go get some changes, when I know something's changed. All right, or I wanna check if something's changed. So now I'm gonna come over here and let's actually get some change data that we can track. So I'm gonna come over here to Alex's profile and we're gonna update his department from sales to marketing. And we're gonna save it. Okay, so at this point, if I was only using Delta Query, I would have to make a hard choice. I would either have to be polling constantly in the background to learn about this change and risk getting back a ton of empty responses saying that there's nothing has been changed and burn up resources that I don't need to use. Or I could poll very infrequently and risk having out-of-date data in my application. But now since we've got webhooks ready for use in production, I don't have to make this hard choice. I can have the best of both worlds. I can wait for webhooks to let me know that something's changed and come back and actually get the change data with Delta Query. Okay, so I've got this sample running here, which already has created a subscription for me. And what's gonna happen is when there's a change to a user object that I care about, I'm gonna get a push notification sent to an endpoint that's associated with an Azure function. And that Azure function is going to drop the notification into a queue, and then I'm using this Azure Web Jobs SDK to monitor that Azure queue for incoming notifications. And as you can see here, I'm hitting the V1 endpoint to create my subscription, and I am tracking changes to users, and I'm looking for updates and deletes specifically. So let's see if we've got some change data. All right, there we go. So here we can see we have a user with a specific object ID that has been updated. So this would let me know it's time to use my Delta token and run Delta Query to see what's actually changed. So let's pop back over to Graph Explorer, and I'm gonna use my Delta token I received last time, and there we go. There's Alex's object ID, and we can see his new department is marketing, and we can go ahead and automatically assign all those open sales leads to Alex's manager. In this video, you've seen how you can use Delta Query to synchronize data or track changes to various resources in Microsoft Graph. You've also seen how webhooks can be used to get push notifications when data changes, and how these two capabilities work better together. We've also talked about some great new features that make these capabilities even more useful. To learn more, including supported entities and queries, please check out our documentation at graph.microsoft.com and try out all of our samples on GitHub, including the one I showed you today. Tell us about what you're working on Twitter and ask us any questions you have on Stack Overflow using the Microsoft Graph tag. Thanks for taking the time to learn about Microsoft Graph, Delta Query, and webhooks with me today.